Morning, my dear students. All of you know, now very tough situation is going on. That's why we teachers, through this video, trying to explain your subjects that at least you can continue your subjects at home. That's why today I am going to explain our subject, and that is geography. And the first chapter of this subject is the Earth as a planet. This is chapter 1. And from this chapter, we are going to discuss, or which one I will explain. These are the topics I mentioned. You please note down. Topic 1. The unique planet Earth. Why? These are the reasons. 5 reasons I have mentioned. Which one I will explain. And our second topic from this chapter, shape of the Earth, which also I will explain. And then these are your homework, which one you have to write in your copy. Definitely I will see that one, I will check that one. And first question I have given, geoid or oblate spheroid. Second one I have given, ecosystem. Third one, food chain. Number 4, circumnavigation. And then here I have given one question. But one thing I want to say, these 4 words completely new for you. And I have given you these 4 as your homework. But before that, definitely I will explain today. Number 2, explain Bedford Canal experiment. This is also a new for you. But I will explain, but at home you will explain this theory after listen my class with the diagram. And the last question I have given, that is I mentioned to page number 7 and 8 in your book. Here 2 things are there, one knowledge booster, another fact life about our Earth's dimension. You prepare these 2 table, I will ask question from there. But few more homeworks are left, which one I will give you definitely. Before starting our lesson, our topic, first topic, I want to say something. Up to standard 8, you have followed one pattern of question. This time you will follow completely different pattern. So you should know the pattern, what type of question you are going to get this year. So that pattern I will explain after reopening the school. And the second thing, that one is very important, that few things when I will explain each chapter, few things I will skip. Few things, not everything. Few things I will skip. Why? Because those topics are out of ICSE syllabus. So listen this video very carefully, which topics I am going to skip. That one don't prepare, because that one out of ICSE syllabus. And the third one, very important thing, that one, if you think that after reopening our school means we'll again discuss the topic, discuss the chapter, wrong. You prepare this chapter, I will explain only, I will clear your doubts only. After listen this class, after listen these videos, you mark your doubts. I will explain, I will clear your doubts only. And the homework, which one I have given you, that part I will definitely check. So you have to do your homework in the copy. So keep these 3 things in your mind. Topic, the Earth as a planet. Yes, unique planet. The Earth is a planet. All of you know, size-wise, it is 5th largest planet. Okay, but it is also called unique planet. Why? Because these 4 reasons. First of all, optimum distance from sun. Yes, our distance from the sun, you know, the sun is the source of heat and energy, and our distance means our Earth, that distance is optimum, neither too close nor too far from Earth. And in average, we can say it is 150 million kilometers. In average, we can say 150 million kilometer. That's why our earth is neither too hot nor too cold. Second one is presence of hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means, all of you know, layer of water. So on this planet, means our earth, enough water is present in different forms. So life can exist here. And the presence of favorable atmosphere. Yes, we have the layer of atmosphere which consists different gases, and different gases have their own importance. So those gases are very important to exist our life on this planet. And the third one, lithosphere, which is also called crust, solid surface of Earth, where we can live. We means all living organism, all non-living organism can live, can stay. Lithosphere, very important. That's why our Earth is a unique planet. So it's a very simple thing. If this question comes, why Earth is called a unique planet? Very simple. Because life can exist here. Because life can exist here. How is it possible? Because of this four reasons. We have optimum distance from the sun. We have hydrosphere. We have favorable atmosphere. And we have lithosphere. That's why this layer can exist. Biosphere. Yes, what is the meaning of biosphere? Layer of life. This layer formed due to the presence of this four. That's why Earth is a unique planet. I said that Earth is a unique planet. Why? There are four reasons already I have mentioned. There are four reasons I already said Earth is a unique planet, and there are four reasons which I already mentioned. And due to that four reasons, one new layer formed, that is called biosphere. I said the meaning, sphere of life. This life can develop, can exist over the planet, over the Earth, due to that four reasons. Now, this biosphere means what? Sphere of life. So I am going to say about something this layer. Life means many organisms. We know the human beings are the most developed organism, but except human, there are many organisms. They are called living organisms. I am talking about living organisms. So many living organisms are present on this layer or coming under this same category, biosphere. And these living organisms, they are interrelated. Why? Because of energy, because of food. That interaction of all living organisms on this earth surface is called ecosystem. It is called ecosystem. Different types of living organisms, small, big, bigger, they can interrelated with each other because of food, because of energy. And that's why this ecosystem developed. And when one ecosystem we get, complete ecosystem, that ecosystem can develop with the help of food chain. Because on this planet, we have different ecosystems. We have land ecosystem, we have forest ecosystem, we have desert ecosystem, pond ecosystem, many ecosystems develop. Everywhere organisms are present and they are interrelated. That's why different ecosystem develops. And when they develop, they complete their energy cycle with the help of this food chain. How? The source of energy is only one, that is sun. Sun gives us energy. And with the help of this energy, producer can make the food. And on this earth surface, only one producer we have, that is different types of trees or plants. And from these producers, energy transfers towards consumers. Consumers mainly three types, that is herbivore, carnivore and omnivore. And from these consumers, this energy transfer where? Decomposer. who are very small in size. These organisms are very small in size. Microscopic organism they are. And from them, energy transferred to the soil and soil towards again plants. So, now this way we are getting a complete cycle which is called food chain. So, that's why I said one ecosystem, you can take any one example. Pond one, land one, forest one, any one ecosystem you can take as an example. And you can see that it started from sun to producer, producer to consumer, consumer to decomposer and again producer. Like this way we are getting one complete food chain. So ecosystem is very important because biosphere means, again I am telling, life, layer of life, and this life can exist on the earth surface through this ecosystem and food chain. Understood? Now our second topic, which one I already mentioned, the shape of the earth, because this was the part of unique planet. Our first topic, there were two topics I already mentioned. Today I am going to explain. First one was unique planet, which one I said. Now the second one, shape of the earth. Yes, what is the shape of earth? If I ask you, all of you know it is circular, it is spherical. But in geography, it has proper term. And the term is oblate spheroid. Means, if you take a globe, you can see our center part of the earth, which is called equatorial area. That one is bulged. And top, which is called poles. These two areas are flattened. This kind of shape is called oblate spheroid because it proves that our earth is not complete spherical, complete circular. Its middle part bulged and top and bottom part flattened. One, if you take the diameter, if you know the diameter of our earth, equatorial area, it is 12,756 kilometers. And polar area, it is 12,714 kilometer. And we can see it is higher than this figure. So it is proved that this figure is, this portion is bulged. So this kind of shape is called oblate spheroid. Now you can think that why this kind of shape developed, middle portion bulged, top and bottom portion flattened. Reason is rotation. I think you know, student of standard 9, what is the meaning of rotation. Rotation means when planets, mainly our earth, rotates on their own axis. One type of force developed called Coriolis force. And the speed of this force is very high in this center part. That's why center portion is bulged. And that's why we are getting this particular shape, oblate spheroid. I was talking about shape of the earth. Now what is the shape? Now I think it is clear, oblate spheroid. What is the meaning of the shape? I explained, equatorial area is bulged, polar areas are flattened. Why this type of shape is developed? Because of rotation. So now these points which one I have mentioned here, these are the some experiments. These experiments already proved that yes, earth has this specific kind of shape which is called oblate spheroid. And these 9 experiments, I have mentioned all names, all are important. But according to me, I want to tell that number A, the time of sunrise and sunset. Number C, Magellan's circumnavigation. Number D, number E, number G and number H. Very important and very clear experiments. One by one I am going to explain all. So number one first. The time of sunrise and sunset. We know the time of sunrise and sunset in case of all places not same. You take as an example, you take our country. our easternmost and our westernmost country, there are 2 hours time gap. And in between this, sunrise and sunset time is not same. Why? Because of this shape. Here sunrise timing and here sunrise timing differ. Suppose, had the earth been flat, the sunrise and sunset at every place would have been same if it is flat. But no, our shape of the earth is this. That's why time differ. Next one is the horizon. I think many of you know the meaning of horizon. Horizon means where sky and land meet. If we stand in open area, we can see far from our distance that sky and that field meet. That line is called horizon. Actually, this line is very thin line. But if height of the surface increases, the horizon also widens. Why? Because of this shape of the earth. Now, circumnavigation theory, a very clear one. Circumnavigation Magellans is a person name, full name Ferdinand Magellans. This person with his group navigated our whole earth. But finally, they didn't get any sharp edge. That's why it is very clear that our earth has a spherical shape, not a flat one. Sighting of a ship from the seaport. Very clear experiment. If we observe that one ship approaching towards seaport, first what we can see? First we can see the top part of the sea. If we stand here, we can see the top part first. Why? Because of this ship. When ship will come close to the ship seaport, we can see the whole body of the ship. Because of the ship. Second one, Bedford Canal experiment. This one I will explain last after completion all. So now, lunar eclipse. You know the lunar eclipse meaning. Lunar eclipse means, you know, when sun, earth and moon, these three celestial bodies are coming in a straight line. And earth comes in the center, in the middle of sun and moon. And we can see the shadow of earth on this body, moon, which prove the shape of the earth is spherical. Oblique spheroid. Aerial photographs is a very modern method, modern techniques. With the help of satellites, now we can take our Earth's photo from the space. Okay, and those photos already proved that the shape of the Earth is oblique spheroid. Position of the pole star. It is another one pole star, you know. It is located in the northern pole. It has the fixed position. And our latitude, it varies from pole to equator. The angle of North Pole also varies. Why? Because of the shape. If our earth is flat, then we will get different angles. Then we will get same angle. But we are not getting same angles. We are getting different angle from different latitudes. Why? Because of the shape of earth. And the last, the earth as a heavenly body. This point is also important, but a very simple point, this one, that many heavenly bodies are present. And all bodies, maximum bodies, they are rotated. And due to this rotation, I told already, due to this rotation, this kind of shape develop. So many are there, many planets are there, sun is there, moon is there, our earth also is there. That's why the earth as a heavenly body, it has oblate spheroid shape. And the last one, Bedford Level Canal experiment. This experiment actually done in England in a canal. The person taken actually three poles, same height of the height of that three poles, and that pole were placed in a canal where distance was fixed. Means if these are the three pole, the distance between these two each pole was same, that was 5 kilometers, and the height of the poles were same. And under water, suppose this is the water level, okay, in a short I am writing water level, same length was there, suppose 10 centimeters, okay, 10 centimeters, and I told you pole's height are also same. Suppose pole height was 20 centimeters, so under water was 10 centimeters, so definitely above water how much is left? Again 10 centimeters. Okay, now after doing this part, he observed this three pole with the help of telescope, and what was the result? This middle one was taller than these two. Why? Because of this shape of the earth. And this experiment proved that earth has particular shape which is called oblate spheroid. I've already given few homework when I started this lesson. Now two more questions I am giving you, three different questions I have already mentioned, I think all of you have noticed. Now number four, give reason. Two questions, two reasons you have to write. First one, moon cannot support life like earth. Give reason. Actually we know moon is our natural satellite and it is very close to our earth. Earth is a unique planet. Life can exist there, but moon cannot support. Why? Because lack of gravitational force, and due to that moon cannot hold atmosphere, and that's why daytime here temperature is very high and nighttime temperature is very low, and that temperature cannot support to exist life there. And the second one, plants are also called producer. Yes, this one very clearly I didn't say, I only said the only producer on this earth, that is plant, which can absorb sun energy and can make the food. You try to write this answer. After that, I will check that one. So finally, I can say that our chapter has completed, and the homework which one I have given you student, you at least try to write that answer. I will definitely check that one. And your doubt, you read the chapter and mark your doubt after reopening the school. I will clear your doubts definitely.